Hey guys, so welcome back. In the last video, we went through the process of importing photos into Lightroom Classic. If you haven't watched that video yet and you have questions about importing photos, I will leave the link to that video in the description. So far we have 40 images in our catalog. It's pretty easy to find the photos that we're looking for. But what happens several years down the road when you have 40,000 photos in your Lightroom catalog? It can definitely become a challenge to find that one specific photo that you need. So today we're going to talk about one of the most important things that you can do in Lightroom, and that is organizing your photos. Now, Lightroom has several ways that you can organize your library, and if you take the time to learn and use a system to organize your photos, it will make your life much easier in the future. In this video, we will organize the file system and we will work with collections. Now, the first thing that I like to do right after importing is going into the Folders tab over on the left-hand side of the screen. The Folders tab is a direct representation of the folder structure that is on the hard drive where we imported our photos. In here, we can rename folders, we can create new folders, and we can move your photos in between those folders. Now, make sure that you're only doing this within Lightroom. If you open your hard drive in your operating system's File Explorer and make changes there, it will break the link between Lightroom and your photos, and Lightroom won't know where to look for your images. Okay, so let's see what we've got. So each photo was placed in a folder for the year that it was taken. From there, Lightroom has broken this down even further, so if we open up that 2018 folder, we'll see that Lightroom has created four subfolders. These are the specific days that I took these images. Now, you'll notice that the folders don't tell us anything other than that. I can't tell what is in the folders other than that I took them on that specific date. And we're going to fix that. So when I click on the September 9th, 2018 folder, I see that there are four photos that I shot on the North Shore of Minnesota. So I'm going to rename this folder. So we just right click on that folder. We come down and choose rename, and a dialog box pops up. Now I want to leave that date. So I'm just going to add Minnesota North Shore to the end of that name. Now, when I'm browsing my folders, I'll know that this folder contains four photos that were taken on the North Shore of Minnesota. So we'll just hit save, and you notice it renames that folder in this file structure right here. It's also renaming that folder on your hard drive. Okay, now we can break it down even further than that. Two of these photos were taken at a place named Hollow Rock Resort. The next one was taken at the Baptism River. And the third one was taken at Black Beach Park near Silver Bay, Minnesota. So I'm going to select the two photos that were taken at Hollow Rock by clicking on the first one, holding the Shift key down, and clicking on the second photo. And you'll notice that highlights these two photos. Next, I'm going to right-click on the folder that I just renamed and choose Create Folder Inside. This will give us another dialog box. I'm going to name this folder Hollow Rock. I like to check the box that is marked Include Selected Photos. Okay, then I'm going to click Create. Now, if you go over here and you expand this folder, we have a new folder named Hollow Rock. And Lightroom has automatically moved those two photos into this folder for us. So now I'm going to come up here and I'm going to select the photo of the Baptism River. Again, I'm going to right click, create a folder inside, and this one we're going to name Baptism River. And again, we'll just click create. And you'll notice that it created a Baptism River folder with one photo inside. So finally, I'm going to come over here. I'm going to select the photo from Black Beach Park. Okay, and I'm going to do the same thing. Right click, create a folder inside. And this one I'm going to name Silver Bay. Black Beach Park. And I'll hit enter, create that folder. So now we have the date folder renamed to let us know what is in it, and three subfolders under that one that drills down the specific location where the photos were taken. Okay, so I've just finished organizing the folder structure from the photos that we imported in the last video. I try to do this after I import photos every time. It just makes life so much easier. Another way that we can organize is by sorting photos into collections. So when you expand the collection tab on the right-hand side, you will see an option for smart collections. Now, I'll explain smart collections later on, but right now we just want to explore normal collections and collection sets. Collections are how we group like photos together. I'm going to click on the plus sign next to collections and choose Create Collection Set. Now, you don't have to use collection sets. You can just choose to create a collection, but I have thousands of photos from different locations in the state of Minnesota, so I want a collection set that will contain multiple collections of photos from different locations. I'm going to name this collection set Minnesota. And then I will click Create. Now, if you come back over to this left-hand side of the screen, you'll notice that it created a collection set named Minnesota. There are no photos in there, but the collection set is there and it's ready to go. So now I'm going to click that plus sign again, but this time I'm just going to create a collection. In the box that pops up, I'll name the collection North Shore. Now, this time I want to check the box that's marked inside a collection set, and that'll give us a drop-down box. We can come down here and you'll notice we have a smart collection set and the Minnesota collection set. I want to choose the Minnesota collection set. I don't want to include selected photos on this round. So we'll uncheck that and we'll come down and we'll hit create. You'll see that it created a North Shore collection in the Minnesota collection set. Now all we have left to do is to move the photos that we want into that collection. So to do that, I like to hold the Control key and start selecting the photos that I want to include in this set. All right, so I've got all my photos selected, and we just simply click in the middle of one of the photos, hold the button, and drag them into that North Shore collection. You'll notice it put those 15 photos that I just selected right in there. Now, I'm going to go ahead and continue on and sort the rest of these images that we imported in the last video, and I'll be back when I'm done. So I've gone through, I've made my collection sets, I've made my collection under those sets. So, like, if we hit Minnesota, we have all of our North Shore photos in one single collection. We can go to Michigan, and again, I have all of my photos from the Upper Peninsula of Michigan in one collection. Okay, and we can break this down even further. We can put sets into set and then break down collections even further than what I've done here. Okay, so today we've learned how to organize our folder structure, and we've learned how to create collections in Lightroom. This makes it a lot easier to find the photos that you're looking for later on. Okay, again, if you found this video helpful, go ahead and click that like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell notification so that you're notified every time I put a new video up in this video series about Lightroom. Okay, y'all have a good day, and we'll see you next time.